That's all right, isn't it? We've had to cut the fence panel down. It wouldn't go round the side of the house to get the digger in. He got stung by wasps, just like I did the other day, didn't you?
Yeah.
So we might have a little bit of a problem with the wasp a little bit later. Come and see what we're doing today. And I can't do any work because I've got a bad shoulder, believe it or not. See you in a minute. It's like a bloody new wheelbarrow, that one, isn't it?
We've had it 6 years.
So we've got three amigos. We've got two wheelbarrows. I thought we were supposed to have one more wheelbarrow, Gary. Oh, you've got a wheelbarrow each then. Go and get it, Jimmy.
Oh, yeah.
Come on.
I'm not on the books yet.
And I can't do anything because I'm not well, because I've got a bad shoulder. That's a shame, isn't it? So, yeah, as I say, that wasp nest, Gary was over there strimming the other day. And, he was coming in from that side and he got attacked and it hit him right in the throat. So they're in there somewhere. We have got some wasp spray, but apparently wasp nests are underground somewhere. So they are floating about here, but we're going to leave that bit till last anyway. So we're not too sure how we're going to deal with that yet. That's the tool, Alex. So much easier when you've got the right gear, innit? You got stung? Go and take an antihistamine. Get that, we get the wasp spray out in a minute. Jimmy's just been... Fuckers. Fuck me, they're coming out to attack us. They're coming out to attack us. Did you just get stung? Well, we're gonna have to do something about this, aren't we? Yeah, he was only working in that area and he got stung as well. Jimmy's just got stung as well. So we'll have to hold fire for a minute. We'll come back to you and we'll see you in a minute, all right? We're gonna sort this out, hopefully. Right, we've just seen a big... The nest is not in the ground. It's actually where he's squirting the foam at the moment. So we're covering it with a... the foam at the moment, but the nest is a big one, isn't it? You saw it?
Yeah, it's a big one, yeah.
So there we go, it's not underground, so it is out on show, so we're going to squirt it with that foam. They're not very happy at the moment, but so we've got to keep back because who knows what they're going to be like, but it's not underground anyway. What about that, Sharon?
Very good.
Hey, I didn't see it when I was squirting it, you see.
We want it in your bedroom, let's put it that way.
Yeah, I couldn't see it when I looked in there, as I say, but Gary came from the other side, one stung him on the throat.
What time can you bring up, Skip?
9 o'clock. That's the time it opens.
Give him a bell now, I'm not running in the office.
Yeah.
That wire's not attached to nothing, Jimmy, that is it?
Well, I thought I got stung pulling out.
Oh.
No, that wire, that it might plug.
Did it plug
in?
I
unplugged
it.
Well, you didn't get that good, did you?
Yeah, that's not plugged in, that's just wrapped around the pole of it.
Plugged in.
Eh?
It was plugged in.
Yeah, but it's not working. The power switched off. I've turned the power off. Keep that can of stuff on the. No, the other one, the spray.
That is it.
That's the foam, Sharon.
That's the power.
No,
the other
spray.
Stuff.
Oh, is it? Oh, I thought you had a...
Listen to me, that's a powder.
Sorry, baby.
But I said, if not, I'll go down the road and get another one. It's simple, isn't it?
Yeah. All right, well, let's see what happens here then. He's going to try and squash it, maybe. Hey? Yeah, we've all got our sleeves on show, look. I don't know if you can see it or not, but
you, it,
yeah, go on in.
Okay.
It's absolutely enormous.
Yeah.
Where he's just squirted, that's exactly where it is. It's enormous, Sharon. Coming from a different angle. That's it. I can't see any flying about at the moment, so right. Well, I squirted it, but it's absolutely enormous in there. There we go. Look, this is doing a great job, isn't it? You can't do it without one of these. Look. What do you reckon?
It's nice.
Hey?
Nice.
You got the foreman on the job now, Charlotte. Look. Sharon's involved. Not Jimmy. What's that?
Jimmy's the engine.
Not a pantomime.
It's not a pantomime.
Jesus.
Frit the life out of him, Sharon.
I thought it was going to sting him because he'd come from up there and went to
him. Yeah. What we could have done with is a flame gun. I've had two of them and I got rid of them. I sold them. Now I could have wanted one. The thing is, the skip's not turned up yet. It's supposed to have been here yesterday and we can't phone them up till 9 o'clock and it's only 8:45 because we want to start wheelbarrowing all this stuff out, you see, but we can't do it at the moment. Where's that cable coming out of the ground, Jimmy? There. Is that the one that goes in the ground? That's probably the supply cable to feed. Or is it? Oh no, that might have been the one that went to the actual pump.
An ex-electrician, look at that.
I didn't put that in, that was in the house when we come here.
Cut. Should we get the spade?
Yeah, cut round it, see what, I don't know how it's fixed, you see. It'd be handy to get it out in one piece.
Is it in the concrete or?
I would imagine it's fixed to the concrete via some lugs.
That's what you just said.
Hey?
It's good soil.
Yeah, it looks good soil, yeah. Start digging around there. That's just the wood around the edge. That's the thing, see, that's how hard it is when you've got just hand tools. Getting there, isn't it? See, there's a concrete plinth under there, isn't it, I would have thought. But I don't know whether it's screwed to them. Oh, here we go. What's Alex? What you found there, Alex? That's it then. They're bolted, isn't it? Is it bolts?
Do you want to keep them
or? Well, I want to keep it if possible, yeah. Yeah, we don't want to damage this lamppost if we can help it. It looks like a pretty good lamppost, you see. So we're going to try and cut it off at the post, cut the head side off the bolts. There's only a couple there, isn't there? Three or four? Down the side, isn't it? Just go down the side, Jimmy. No, straight down the side of the bolt.
What? That way?
Straight down the side of the nut.
Yeah,
you're going to have to go. Oh, better go on the outside, isn't it? They look like stainless steel nuts. There's a pile of bricks there, and all slabs. Those are slabs there, we'll have to lift them up. Some last few slabs there, isn't it? Mind the wasps if this. If you see any, run. Yeah. Yeah. No, it's a bumblebee. Yeah, but you don't know how far down it goes, do you? Solid old block, that, isn't it? You ain't got it plugged in, Jimmy. Would help.
Go on.
Just the nuts holding it on, isn't it?
Should be up
there. Oh, straight over my nut. Right, that cable will have to be cut.
Can I get the bike
up? I need, eh?
The
bike up. Yeah, get a pair of pliers.
Is it off, yeah?
Yeah. But I need the cable in the ground to stay, obviously. That's got to be pulled back to wherever it comes from.
The white cable cutting.
The white cable cutting, yeah. Well, just chop the white one. It might be alive, Alex.
We'll let you do it.
There. Right, get that out of the way. Nice lamppost, that.
Where does that fall back to?
Where?
Fall back to the house, but...
This goes back to the house, yeah, but it goes... Did it go through that slab? I can't see, Alex. So maybe go round that slab. If we leave that slab there, then... Yeah. We might still utilise that, you see. Because we ain't got no need to go lower than that. The cable's obviously buried into the slab, isn't it? So, might as well put a bloody lamp back there, in the middle of the grass or whatever.
9 o'clock. Go running.
No, do it now. Do it now. Phone him up now. Right, he's going out with a wasp nest. Any movement?
Literally an air fryer. Look.
Be careful, Jimmy. We have given it a good spray. Just be careful.
Just one come out there, look. Watch out.
Watch out, he's an attacker.
One more there.
Bloody hell, they're coming out.
Might not be that many.
Eh?
Might not be that many.
Oh, I don't know, Alex. Just be careful. Squashing it, look. A couple have come out, haven't they? What's that? He's getting his own back for stinging him. Oh!
One there behind red.
That must have killed quite a lot of them. What? What, Alex? What, a load of them? Have we got any more powder? Lash it in there, Jimmy. The nest is in there, isn't it, somewhere? There's a couple floating about in there. But for the amount that there was, oh yes, yeah, go on. Couple of little soldiers floating about in there. Well, it looks like all the wasp nest is gone now, so we're literally waiting for the skip to turn up, which isn't here yet. Should have been here yesterday. It's now 9:05. Jimmy's been on the phone to him, and apparently it's on its way, but who knows? Because we need this lot now, we'll barrel it out, so. We're very near now, clearing all this, so yeah, we'll put you on a bit of time lapse. You can watch it on time lapse. See you in a minute. I can't lift anything, I've got a bad shoulder. Where was that nest?
It's up there, I think.
Oh, is it? You're gone?
Yeah, it's gone.
You buried it?
Yeah. Squashed it.
Well, that was easier than what I thought, to be honest with you.
I thought it was going to be a lot worse than that.
I can't do anything. Who's your wheelbarrow made by, Alex? Fisher Price? Hey? Was it Tommy? I've got a pump, we've got a compressor, Alex.
Oh, that's all
We're supposed to have another wheel back, eh? It's the Charlotte, you got the phone over there, haven't you?
Yeah.
Oh, hello. Who's that we're ringing? Oh.
They're dead.
They're dead. Flattened them, squirted them with poison.
So now you have to go on and watch that. See, they've got to watch. Was it Retro Restore?
Retro. No, this is Butler's Empire, Sharon.
Butler's Empire, and then they can see the nest.
I can't physically do anything, Sharon.
Yeah, Butler's Empire, please. Here's Mr. Retro.
Oh, hello.
Come, Mr. Retro Hacks.
It's Martin Butler.
We're live on air.
Mean, look.
We're live on air.
Look, he's got the camera ready. Oh, that's a very
we're actually filming, so no swearing.
Have a look in, he said.
Hey?
We've got the mic, though. Look, we've got the professional mic.
Of course we have.
And men at work. There we go, that's men at work.
What you got there, Alex? Energy drink. What is it?
Arctic coffee.
Arctic coffee? What's that then? Is that like a modern thing, is it? Or?
Very modern, yeah.
Yeah? Does that give you a bit of oomph? Look at this lovely wheelbarrow of Alex's, look. Yeah, the blinking wheel's totally flat. Look, there's no air in it. No, look, it's got nothing on it. The inner tube's total, look. Was it pumped up?
Yeah, it was solid, yeah.
Oh, Alex, what have you done? There's no valve on it.
Oh,
I can't do nothing. There's no valve on it.
There isn't there?
Where's the valve? There's no. Oh, it's valve this side.
There you go, get it jacked up.
Oh, I can't lift it, Jimmy.
Come on, you've got to do something.
Go to the compressor then. Wheel it over there. I've got a pump thing, I think, are we?
That ain't going to reseal.
It's in the tube. Right, big improvements now. We've had to order another skip. I'll show you the skip in a minute. We got an 8-yarder, as you know. You can only put soil and rubble in an 8-yarder, not a 12-yarder, but it's leveled most of it out now. So I've just ordered the skip and it should be here later on this afternoon. So we're gonna actually use quite a bit of this soil because it's actually good soil. They're digging all the weeds out of it. As you can probably see, the quality of it's actually very, very good. And rather than pay 40 odd pound a ton, he's going to level it all out. They're just de-weeding it, so to speak. So that's what they're pulling out of it. Look, so getting rid of all that, and then we're left with good soil. So here's the base of it now, as you can see. We've got a couple more tiles to lift here now. This is near enough leveled now. You only want to rake all this over, sort of thing. So with what's left here, it'll all be raked over. And then it's a matter of tamping it down and then obviously seeding it. So the weather looks like it could possibly rain, so we've got to be careful. And no sign of the wasps anymore. You was going golf today, Alex, weren't you?
I was.
And he chose to come and do this. Look at that, look, amazing. Easily bought, all it's taken is a bottle of Coke to buy him. Yeah, so we've got to get these slabs moved now because that membrane, as you can see, goes underneath it and we're hoping just to rip it out or whatever, as much as what we can anyway, so. I'm going to keep this rubble, as you know, because we're going to hopefully backfill all that. It's starting to look like a pretty decent space now. This stuff here, as you can see, look, the membrane goes underneath it, look. Look, see? So this is an 8-yard skip, and as you can see, we've filled it up now, so that's why, hopefully, I've got another one turning up today. Mostly full up with earth, but we're going to keep the rubble because we're going to backfill the bit in front of the polytunnel with the rubble there, just smash it up and use it. So that's what we plan to do there. And I cleared all this side barrier down the side of the house. Let me show you. I think I'll show you a clip of what it used to look like. And coming down here now, this is what it looks like now. Now you probably remember that this was totally overgrown along there. And I've done this myself the other day, and there should have been a gate going across here just before them pipes there, and the gate was working perfectly. So the gate at the minute is sitting over here, because when I told Jimmy about that, about the gate opens perfectly, he opened it the wrong way and he pulled it off his hinges. That's what he done. You hear that, Gary? He pulled it off the hinges, Gary. Jimmy, that gate was working perfectly. It's not been open for years and years. And he pulled it the wrong way and pulled it off its hinges. How about that? You ain't got time to sit down, boy.
Site foreman.
Hey?
Foreman.
The site foreman standing up there.
I've already filled that.
Yeah, that's an 8-yarder. totally full. A lot of that is the weeds, which you saw them digging off there. So a lot of the earth, I mean, it's really good quality earth. Look, you just got to de-weed it. So that's what we're hopefully using. There's not too,
nice.
Eh?
Smells nice.
It's nice earth, Pete. But it's you'd never dig this up by hand with all these weeds in it, as you can see. So anyway, that's an 8-yarder, but if it don't come today, we'll just have to pile the earth up out here and then transfer it from here into the new skip when it arrives. That's all we can do. And yeah, after all that, after me clearing all that over there, the digger wouldn't go down the side of the house. So coming out the front, in front of the drive, we had to cut down one of these skinny trees here. And we had to cut a hole in the fence there, as you can see. So it had to happen, but as you can see, we'll put a panel across there and redo that anyway. So that's not too bad. But yeah, just the things you have to do. There's always got to be a plan B. And this was the plan B. It's now become a spectacle sport. Look. One working, the rest doing. No, one working, the rest watching. So virtually there now, there's a tree stump down the bottom there, which is just had to get another bucket for. Tree's the digger. Down here, that's the new bucket, the bigger bucket. And we've got this stump here from a tree that we had here years and years ago. So Alex is just getting rid of all the stuff around it. So then we'll get down to the roots and hopefully be able to pull this out because this is above floor level. So we're just having to pile up the last two piles over there until the second skip turns up, and then we'll wheelbarrow it manually. He might need hand with that bucket, Jimmy. No?
Yeah, all right.
Any time of day, Jim.
I'm not stopped all morning.
Hey, come on, but first I've seen you actually do some work. Oh, he's walked off, look, he's seen Alex giving him hand, he's walked off, look. It's a mighty big stump in there. Dig down either side of it. Of course, a big old tree stump, isn't it? Here we go. That's half of it out. Happy days.
We better put the saw through the middle of that tree.
Yeah, we'll take over that.
Oh, here we go. That's better. Hey, up. Oh, that's the kitty. That's it. Happy days, look at that. In the wheelbarrow. That's rotten, isn't it?
Ready?
Woo! Is that a comedy sketch? So that's my lamppost feed, which I can reuse again. That'll be standing in the middle of the lawn somewhere. And over here is my armoured cable, which used to supply the pond pump. And that again, as I say, that's still underground. I can utilise that somewhere there. And happy day, so I've still got that. Yeah, so that big tree stump there, as you can see, which was in there, now gone. Just bits of rubbish to pull up, and I can do that, as I say, raking along. Done a lot of work there today, then, boys. I'm not too worried about the raised bed. I told them to leave that because that could just be broken up as and when. That's only earth and a few rocks in there. So I'll probably get one more skip to sort this lot out, get rid of all this. And I'll wait till I backfeed all this little area over here and we get some pick straight lines and all that. So just so that we know where we are. He's told me where to get my seed from. £60 a bag or something. Really good quality seed, apparently. He knows a local seed company, so I'm going to obviously seed them, and we'll seed all this, and once we've got the top soil on, tamp it down, seed it, and that should hopefully take. So, we've got that rotavator, haven't we? Which you've got to refurbish.
What, you want to rent it?
That'll work on there, that'll pull up all them weeds, so yeah. If we get that rotavator running, before we actually restore it, or paint it up and all that, put it through the ultrasonic cleaner, the carb, and that should pull up all these leftover little weeds there, but we've taken a hell of a lot of them away. And that's the thing you couldn't do if you just done it on your own with a shovel. I mean, this is the sort of thing that you just can't pull up. And the whole soil was covered with these sort of weeds. Literally loads and loads of them. So that's what we've actually pulled out anyway. Yeah, bring that panel down. We just got to stop the dog getting out for the moment, you know, before I get it repaired properly. So that can sort of go back in place. And then we can get that other little gate thing. That's it, just try and keep it together. That's it, go straight through the screws there. Right, let me go and get a battery drilled in and we'll do that. Then we've got to sort that out thing that you pulled down. Jimmy.
Hiya.
Yeah. Well, there we go, that's the job virtually done now. We just got to smooth this little bit over here. And as you can see, it's given us loads more lawn space now, and I'm totally happy with that. So we've still got some more work to do, just levelling out and stuff, but that'll be raking stuff and all that. So anyway, hope you've enjoyed this little video. And if you do like what you see on my channel, do hit the subscribe button. Also hit the little notification bell. Set your preferences to all. And that way you get notified every time we upload a video. Anyway, the boys have done very well. The time now is 12:45. They've been out here since probably about 8:00. And a hell of a lot of work's been done. And I'm sure you'll agree, we're now moving forward with the garden project. Anyway, thanks very much. I'll see you in the next video. And until then, bye for now.